Hello everyone and welcome to Let's Photoshop. In today's tutorial, we're gonna see how to create this really cool 3D vintage text effects that you can see in here using Adobe Photoshop. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. Okay, so let's go ahead and open Photoshop, and as you can see, I already have a 4K setting document open, which is just like 3840 pixels for the width, 2160 pixels for the height, and I put 150 in the resolution for a change because I want the text to be a little bit sharp. Alright, so after you open a new document, the first thing that we are going to do actually is to go to my folder in here. And as you can see, we're gonna use this color palette to create our text, and also the font that we'll be using, it's called Yesteryear. It's a Google font, it's free. I will make sure to put a link where you can download this, and also we're gonna use this texture from Texture Labs, and that will be all. Alright, so the first thing that we are going to open is these colors, so we'll just drag them and open them and place them just right on top. Next, I will go back to this layer that it's a background, and I will create a solid color, and then I sample the color of the background, which is this pink in here, and I will press OK. Now we can just delete this layer, and let's call this PG for background, and let's delete this layer mask too. Alright, now it's time for us to create our text, so let's go and choose the text in here, and let's just one click, and let's choose vintage. Alright, as you can see, I already have the font in here selected to Yesteryear font. It's only come with the regular, which is fine. I think it looks good. After that, I will just place it in the center, and then I'm gonna press Ctrl or Command T to open the transform mode, and by pressing Ctrl, I can select this point in here, this corner in here, and drag it on top. But while I'm dragging it, I will press Shift for it to be locked. Maybe around minus 10, I think it will look good. Just to have it a little bit tilted in here, it looks much better. And I will one click on this check mark. Alright, now we have our text in here the way we want it. Now I'm gonna right click and choose convert to smart objects for this font in here. The reason why we did this, we can go back and change this to whatever we want using smart objects. Alright, now I'm gonna create 4 copies of this, which is 5 in total. So I'm gonna press Ctrl J 4 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, and now we have 5 of this text in here, and I'm gonna call the first one front, and this one I will call it shape 1, and the other one shape 2, and shape 3, and shape 4. So we're gonna use actually only strokes to make this 3D looking font or text in here. So we're gonna start with the first one. So let me just hide the other four. So we're gonna start with the front text or the front color. So I will go to this FX icon and I will choose blending options. And then I will go to color overlay. And then I will choose the second color that we have in here, that will be the front of our text, and I will press OK. And also I want to apply a drop shadow, so it's a very simple drop shadow, maybe with like a size of 7 pixels with 1 pixel distance, and I will keep the angles at 90 for now, and also the noise, I think I will keep it 5%, and that will be all, and I will press OK. Alright, so that's what we are going to do for the first text. Now we're gonna select the second one that it says shape 1 and make it visible. And for this one, I will make the fill set to 0%. After that, I will go to this FX icon and I will open the blending options again. Alright, as you can see, we already have the fill opacity set to 0. So the first thing that we are going to apply is a color overlay. So I'm just gonna change the color to this third color that we have in our color palette, and I will press OK. Next, I will go to the stroke. And as you can see, I already have the size set to 24 pixel, which is what we want, but it depends on the resolution of your document. You need to experiment with this. The position is set to outside because I want this to look like a little bit 3D in a little bit. And of course, we're gonna keep the blend mode to normal with 100% opacity, but the color I will change it to this third or fourth color that we have in here, which is a little bit darker than the bluish color that we use for the color overlay, and I will press OK. Next, I'm gonna press Ctrl or Command T, and I will drag it a little bit, that's right here. And as you can see, because we have the stroke and the color overlay in a both of them with different colors, it will give this look in here, as you can see, which is what we want. And feel free to actually use your arrow keys to position your text to wherever you want them. Just something just like that, and I will press enter. Alright, so we have our first shape. Now we're gonna go to the second shape that we have, and we'll make it visible. And again, I will make the fill set to 0%. And we're basically gonna do the same. We'll go to this FX icon and choose blending options, and let's go to stroke, and I think we're gonna keep the stroke set to 24, but for the color we're gonna use this yellowish color, and I will press OK. And let's change the color overlay also to this yellow color, so it will be all yellow, and I will press OK. Next, we're gonna place it where we want, as you can see. For it to look 3D, we need to make it like follow the same angle. I mean, it's best if you use your arrow keys to place this, it's much better. You can control it easier like that. Yeah, something like this, I think it looks good. All right, next, I will go to the shape 3 layer in here. And again, I will make the fill set to 0% and open the FX icon and choose blending options. And now we're gonna go again and choose stroke. And for the color, we're gonna use this reddish color in here. And I will press OK. And let's change the color overlay to be all red. Or like it's a little bit orangey, this color actually. And I will press OK. Alright, so it's very simple and easy to do this 3D text. And again, we're gonna put it where it looks a little bit 3D, somewhere in here, I think, using my arrow key, I think it's better. All right, something like that. And I think it looks very good. And then we're gonna go to the shape 4 layer, the last one, and we'll do the same, make the fill 0% and open the blending options. And this time we're gonna go to stroke again and sample the last color that we have and press OK. And let's actually do another color overlay with the same color. And for this one, we're gonna apply a little bit of drop shadow, but I think we're gonna go back and apply it when we're gonna position it where we want it. So I'm just gonna press OK for now, and then I will drag it and choose a spot for it to look 3D using my arrow keys. Alright, something somewhere in here, I think. Yeah, I think it looks really cool like this. Alright, something like that. Now we're gonna go back to the layer size and choose drop shadow. And we're gonna keep the blend mode set to multiply, but for the color, I will open the colors and I will sample this pink color, and I will make it a little bit darker by bringing down the point in here and pressing OK. And then I will change the size to something that is look more interesting, something like this. I think it looks very nice, as you can see. All right, something like that, not that much. And I will keep the noise set to 5%, and maybe I will put up the opacity to like 60%. Yeah, something like that, and I will press OK. Alright, so we are finished with our text. As you can see, it looks really nice. Now it's time for us to apply the texture. So let me group all the text together actually by pressing shift, and while this selects it, I will press shift and select the front color layer in here, and then I'm gonna press Ctrl Command G and let's call this text. Alright, and let's hide these colors in here, and then let's go back to our folder and open the texture, and we're gonna resize it to fill the canvas just like that, and I will one click on this check mark. And for the texture, we're gonna just change the blending mode to soft light and bring down the opacity to like 70 or 60%, and voila, we have our really nice vintage text with a really nice texture on top. And of course, if you want to change the background, you can just double click on this solid color in here and change the background to wherever you like. Maybe make it a little bit desaturated and it will look interesting with whatever background color that you want, but for me I will keep it in this pink color in here. And lastly, we're gonna see how to change the font, or how to change the text. So for you to change the text, you can just one click on one of these smart objects that we have in here, and you can just double click on it like that, or you can just right click and choose edit content, and this will open a new tab with the text on it, and then you can just double click on this text and maybe you can change it to retro, and then you can place it. And if it doesn't fit with the canvas, you can just choose the crop tool and make it bigger for it to fit, just like that. And now we have it in here, and let's do it like this, and then close this tab and make sure to press yes to save it. And there we go, we have the same effect applied on the same text in here, and you can always go back by pressing Ctrl Command Z to the other text, and that will be all. Alright, so I hope that you enjoy and you like this quick tutorial and it was a little bit helpful for you. If you try this or you learn something from this, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like, and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.